characteristic of affliction. It caused suffering. People are suffering so much. That is the affliction. It caused a man or a woman to be locked about here and there. You can be locked there and there. Wherever you go, everything is shut up. Everything is closed down for you. It caused a man or a woman to be locked about here and there. It caused embarrassment and harassment. It caused a person to be knocked down completely. It caused weakness. It caused trouble. It caused a person to be burdened. It caused a person to be distressed. It caused a person to be burdened. A person can be a burden. It causes a person to become a burden. You go to people, you become a burden to people. You beg people, you depend on people, you can't do anything. You become a burden. It causes a person to be distressed. It causes oppression. It causes tormentment. It causes a person to be smited. Facts about the enemy. The facts about the enemy, what the enemy wants to you. It does not want you in a hospital bed. The enemy does not want to see you in a hospital bed, but the enemy wants to see you in a coven or in a castle. You must know that as far as you have a destiny, to purpose, to pursue, there will be a killing agency that will rise up. But God is the ultimate killer. There are many enemies who will not let you use you. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. Jesus, I want to honor you. My God, I thank you. There are many enemies who will not leave you unless they die. There are enemies saying that I will not leave you unless I die. Let them die because they have said so. They will say, if you will succeed anything, they rather die than you getting that thing. Because they have confessed that they will die before you get that thing, let them die in the name of Jesus. Let the word of their mouth kill them in Jesus' name. You have had enemies. Some people say, I rather die than seeing this person getting what he was going to get. Die. Let them die because they have said die. Yes. If you give them space, they will not let you go until they have completed their evil assignment. That is why it is very dangerous for any Christian to backslide now. You may not find your ways back to Jesus before you die. If you do not rise up with the ability of God within you and kill your enemies and kill the killing power, you will be killed. If you don't kill them, if you don't stop them, they will stop you. Therefore, you have to use fire brigade prayer. You have to fire them in the name of Jesus Christ. My God, I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, that you will destroy the works of the enemy. The enemy will not destroy you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you. Yes, it means that you can have headache. You can have all sickness around you. But the enemy doesn't want to let you go. They want you to kill. Do you know just headache? Somebody feel headache and it died. Yes. The Lord will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. So, yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, GK. This is the truth. Kill the affection. Kill them. Don't let them kill you. In the mighty name of Jesus. You know, people have died just ordinary headache. They started feeling headache, and they end up dying. You have to fire prayer. The prayer we are going to do. We are going to fire. Thank you. It means that the headache was one a killing mission and it succeeded. That headache or cancer can be a killer. Unless you kill it, it will kill you. Poverty is a killer. Unless you kill it, it will kill you. There were three brothers living together and were always fighting over food. The brothers were fighting over food because of poverty. I know teachers, some prophets, some churches, they are very greedy and jealous when they see someone is raising up a church. They fight for members. They fight for members. Instead of fighting for the seniors to come to the church, they fight for few members. Therefore, that is affliction. If you cannot stop them, they will stop you. You have to find out how you can stop the enemy that wants to destroy you. The Bible says in 1 John 3:8b, for this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. The works of the devil must be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do not let cancer to kill you. Destroy them by fire. Destroy them by thunder. Destroy them by Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Don't let any sickness in your body to kill you. Destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Destroy them. Destroy them in Jesus' name. Let every cancer die in the name of Jesus. Let every spirit of poverty in your life, in your family, die in the name of Jesus. You command them to die because God is a killer. God is a killing machine. It is God who will kill them in the name of Jesus. Every satanic dream that has been tormenting you the whole night, let them die. Let them not function in Jesus' name. Every chain, every bad lock that you've been locked, I command that lock to be passed in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. My God, I thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory in the name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am going to pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm going to attack your affliction, whatever it is, anything that is working against you, any problem that you are forcing right now, I am going to attack them. I'm going to pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus. I am a praying spiritual warfare prayer. Share this media, share these videos, share this Periscope to your friends. All the prayer are in our website. Go to www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. You will find all these videos there to help yourself and review it, pass it to your friends, or you can record it and you can listen again and again. Do that for saving your life and your family. This is a serious matter. You can be affected. There's a lot of problem that is going on with the families in the homes. This is affliction shall die. Affliction of the devil shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. The Bible says men are afflicted, but the Lord will deliver them all in the name of Jesus. I pray that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray by the power in the blood of Jesus, every source of affliction in your life, I command them to die. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I come against every source of affliction in your life. I command them to die. I take authority against every arrows of affliction in your life. I command them to backfire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, affliction must die in the name of Jesus Christ. Every rain of affliction upon your life, I command them to dry up in Jesus' name. My Father and my God, I take the authority by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command every rain of affliction upon your life, I command them to dry up now in the name of Jesus Christ. My Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you, Lord. I know that God, you are my God. There was a woman, rich. There was a very rich woman who was actually the richest in her family. She had a very comfortable house in a good location. One day she settled down to eat a yam. That was said before her. Suddenly a flock came from nowhere and hopped on the pounded yam. I know you know yam. Everybody knows yam. This woman was very rich. And she was sitting comfortably eating her yam. And then a frog jumped from nowhere and hopped on the yam. She carefully took the bowl of the soup and turned it over the frog and pressed it down, thinking that it would die. To her amazement, when she left the bow, there was no frog, dead or alive. Suddenly, she started feeling numbness in her right arm and legs, and she became paralyzed. She was carried from one hospital to another, from one herbalist to another. Eventually, she was taken to Pentecostal church for prayer. She sat on a corner praying, and the man of God came and asked if she was ready to surrender her life to Christ. She was offended that the man asked her if she knew Christ when she was a chairperson of a lady society. You know, I even personally, there are some ladies who came to our prayers. I asked them if they want to give their life to Jesus, or if they will surrender their life to Jesus, or if they need prayers. Those ladies, they said no. So it is the same thing that happened to this woman. She did not know that it is impossible for 28 out of 30 members of the society or members of the church, they are witchcraft. You might deny Jesus Christ, and you don't know the position you are holding or where you are in that society, the church you are. There are so much witchcraft that are there, and they are the responsible of your problem. Anyway, on second thought, she agreed she was not born again, and she surrendered her life to Christ. Instantly, the power of God touched her. She was stood on her feet and walked home. This is the woman who was eating, very rich woman. She was a chair lady in our church, in our local church. Now, when she was eating, a frog came from nowhere and jumped to her yam, which she was eating. Then the woman just removed the frog and threw it on the floor and covered. So when he looked at the frog, he thought the frog is dead. When he looked at the frog, he didn't see the frog. He didn't know where the frog went. Immediately, the woman was paralyzed. That was a charm. That was witchcraft. And if this woman did not go for deliverance, she could have died. She got paralyzed. Immediately, she started her feet and her hands. She was paralyzed. Many people who are paralyzed, they have a sign. But because they don't know what to do, they end up being paralyzed even to die. That is witchcraft. Therefore, I pray every and affliction of that witchcraft, affliction of that devil, shall die in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father, I thank you, Jesus. I pray that God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I take authority against every agenda of affliction for your life. I command them to go back to the sender in the name of Jesus Christ. I take authority against every agenda of affliction for your life and your family to go back to the sender in the name of Jesus. I command them to go back to the sender. Every affliction, every agenda of affliction, agenda of diffraction to come and affect your children, to come and affect you, in the mighty name of Jesus, I command them to go back to the sender in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Jesus has a killing power. He looked at an unfruitful fig tree and commanded it to die, and it died. When killing forces meet another killing forces, the lesser killing forces must bow in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus killed a tree. He commanded the tree to die, and the tree died in the name of Jesus. Jesus has killed.